Easing allows you to control how a layer property animates between keyframes. There are several different types of easing, each with a wide variety of uses. This video will go through all of the easing types in a light motion and describe some common use cases. Before we get started, there are two important things you should know. First, keyframes define the properties of a layer at a specified time, with animation occurring between them. And easing determines how that animation progresses between each pair of keyframes. For this reason, you must have at least two keyframes for a property of a layer in order to access easing options. The second important thing you should know when working with easing is that lines closer to horizontal represent slower progress, and lines that are closer to vertical represent faster progress. Cubic Bezier curves are the simplest type of easing in light motion. They allow for gradual changes in the speed of animations over time. Drag the handles to customize the curve, or use one of the presets. By default, the curve is constrained within the dotted lines to avoid animating beyond the surrounding keyframes, which can cause undesirable results. Occasionally, however, you might want to go beyond the keyframe values for certain kinds of motion. This can be accomplished by enabling overshoot in the overflow menu. Once enabled, the handles can then be dragged beyond the dotted lines. Tapping this button mirrors the two handles, effectively reversing the rate of change over time. This can be very useful for creating a transition. If you want ease out and ease in curves to be perfect mirrors of each other, just copy and paste the easing curve to the second half of the transition and then reverse it. Cubic Bezier curves are typically used to make the progress of an animation feel smoother and more natural. They can be used to slowly ease something into place or to accelerate gradually from a standstill. With overshoot enabled, they can be used to create anticipation or bounce back. Bounce easing animates a value as if it were affected by gravity, falling towards the final value and then recoiling with a bouncing motion. Gravity in this case is towards the final value, which doesn't have to be in the downward direction, or even be a direction at all. For example, you can use a color. Drag the handle up or down to adjust bounciness, and left or right to adjust the speed of the bounces. More technically, dragging up and down adjusts the coefficient of restitution, and dragging left and right adjusts the influence of gravity. If you adjust the handle so that easing finishes close to a whole number of bounces, the last partial bounce will be removed automatically for a seamless finish. For best results, avoid a lot of quick, small bounces at the end. Tapping this button reverses the rate of change of easing, causing the animation to start with the bouncing motion rather than finishing with it. The most obvious use case for bounce easing is with position keyframes in Move and Transform to animate a bouncing ball. But that's not the only thing it's good for. Use the same easing with Scale in Move and Transform to animate that bouncing ball's shadow. Bounce easing can also be used to create interesting transitions. And don't forget that it also works with effect properties. Elastic easing creates an animation similar to that of releasing a taut spring. It shoots quickly past the final value and then settles into place. Drag this handle up or down to adjust the elasticity of the animation, and left or right to adjust the speed and number of cycles. If you find that the animation starts too aggressively, drag the damping handle downward to limit how far easing can overshoot the final value. As usual, you can tap this button to reverse the rate of change, causing the animation to start with an elastic oscillation rather than finishing with it. Elastic easing is great for animating things that need to appear fluid, springy, or buoyant, such as a ball falling into water. It can also be used to evoke a fun, cartoon-like feeling in simple animations or with position or scale to animate simple shake transitions. Cyclic easing repeats the progression between initial and final values. It can be used to create an animation that cycles back and forth, or even just a simple one-way repeating animation. Drag the easing handle to change between smooth or linear easing for each cycle. Smooth easing is based on a sine wave, and linear easing is based on a triangle or sawtooth wave. Drag the bias handle to adjust the balance between the attack and the decay of each cycle. Drag it all the way to one side for a simple one-way repeating animation. Finally, the frequency handle controls the number of cycles, and the damping handle controls whether the animation eventually settles into the final target value. Cyclic easing is very versatile. It is an easy way to loop any animation. A boat on rough seas, the color of a flashing siren, and the text on a scrolling sign are a few examples. Random easing introduces an element of controlled randomness to the progression of the animation, similar to the effects of Brownian motion. Drag the main handle up and down to adjust the magnitude of the random fluctuations, and left and right to adjust the frequency of the randomness. Drag the seed handle up or down to tune the pattern of randomness. Random easing can be used with opacity animation to create flicker, or with position or rotation animation to add some roughness to movement, such as when animating old machinery. It is also useful in low frequency, high magnitude configurations for animating wobbling or shaking motion, or animating some kinds of shake transitions. Steps easing animates in discrete intervals rather than smoothly between the surrounding keyframes. It is somewhat similar to the time quantization effect, but offers more control and can be applied to individual properties rather than a whole layer at once. Drag the main handle left or right to control the number of steps. Drag the easing handle left or right to control whether each step starts abruptly or gradually with easing. Steps easing is useful for animating things that move in increments, such as a worm inching forward or a marquee sign lighting up one bulb at a time. Elastic steps easing is similar to steps, but with an elastic bounce at the step rather than smooth easing. Drag the main handle left or right to control the number of steps. Drag the easing handle up or down to adjust the amount of elasticity at the beginning of each step. Elastic steps is great for animating mechanically stepped motion, such as the movement of an analog clock. It works well for other properties too, such as shifts in color or opacity. Thank you for watching this video on light motion easing types. Please try each of these easing types in one of your projects and feel free to show us what you make with a video link in the comments. If you have any questions at all, please feel free to comment on this video and we'll do our best to answer them. If you haven't already, please be sure to like and subscribe for more videos about light motion.